Hello, everyone. Rodney here with Klebs Tech, and today I'm going to show you how to take a real product image and have an AI model hold that product using Fooocus. I have had plenty of people ask for a video on this, so here it is. Now, if you're not familiar with Fooocus, I do recommend giving it a try because it is really easy to download and run and very easy to use. It is another useful tool to have in your AI toolbox. I do have plenty of other videos on using Fooocus that you can check out as well. The picture on the left is actually a real picture. I went through my files, found one that worked. And that's the one I'm going to use for this. And I'm going to show you how to basically take and create like the ones here on the right that I've already done. And by putting those the product into the model's hands. Now, in order to do this, you can do this. We're going to do a lot of in-painting with this. One thing I do prefer to do when I'm doing something like the can or the project or anything like that, I find it's easier if we just go ahead and make the mask outside of Fooocus instead of manually doing it. Because there is a feature where you can enable mask upload. And so I'm gonna go ahead and create a mask like this. The black part will be the can it shows through. The white part will be the masking area, which will be in painting. So why don't I show you how I quickly, how I create the mask myself. And then right after that, we'll jump into Fooocus. So if you don't need to know how to make the mask, you can skip right ahead to that part. Okay, so the way I usually do it is I use whatever tool you wanna use. To remove the background, I use Adobe Express. I find that works pretty well to at least get me started. And once I've done that, I just go ahead and download the image. And that way I can bring it into something else. I usually use GIMP, which is what I'll be using here. So once I have that, I'll bring it over into GIMP. I'm gonna first go ahead and just change the canvas size. I wanna get this image to a proper resolution that Fooocus uses. So once I've gone ahead and changed my canvas size, I have that where I want it. Then I'm gonna go ahead, I just erase anything else that I did, whatever the background removal didn't remove. A lot of them, sometimes you have to clean them up more. How you do it is up to you, it really doesn't matter. Now, once I have that, I'll add myself a new layer. Make it a white layer. I'll put that at the bottom. Now that I have that, I make sure to select the layer with the can. I should probably save this first so I have this image. So this will be the image that I'll actually use initially for the in-painting because all I need is the can. The rest of it doesn't matter. So now I'll go ahead and I'm just gonna go up in here, go to the colors, change the levels. And I'm gonna adjust that just so it's all black. Anything that's black is gonna show through. The white is the actual mask. So if I were to manually paint mask all around the can, it would be the white areas. Okay, now that we have our images prepared, we're gonna go ahead into Fooocus now. And we should be able to pretty much do most of this in Fooocus from this point on. We will do possibly some resizing. I'm gonna be using the quality setting. I've set my size and aspect ratio to what I had put the image at. I'm gonna just do about 8 images at the moment. And the styles, I just have the standard styles set up for the moment. That's perfectly fine. Model, I'm running Juggernaut version 8 at the moment. The other thing is you wanna go in advanced in the developer debug mode. And we are going to, if we're gonna be using the mask that we created, if you're just gonna be painting the mask on yourself, you don't need to do this. But if you are gonna be using the mask, you want to upload, then you want to enable mask upload. Now, once you've checked that off, you'll notice over here, the in-paint, you'll have 2 boxes in here. You can do it the other way and just drop the image in and then mask over it manually. I find this way works better. It gets a better edge. Everything else I have set on standard. So let's see here. Then we're going to take our image with the background removed, right? I'm gonna put that in the left-hand side. Put our mask on the right. Oh, let me go on random. Okay, let's go ahead and see what happens. The biggest thing here I find is by doing this, generating it real close up like this, we're gonna get much better hand finger placement. You're still gonna get messed up hand, just you won't get as many, I find. That's my opinion on it. Because it can get close up, it has more detail of those hands. Getting it the right proportions can be another problem. Like the can, I find a lot of times I get the can either too big or too small. And getting it where it's pretty close to the right proportions of the hand, that can be a struggle as well sometimes. And whenever I'm generating images, if I, but I do this, I'm usually sitting here. And in the moment, it's not looking right, I just skip to the next one. The other thing is, what'll happen is it'll add a little bit to the edge to get those fingers to go around. Now, sometimes that'll be fine, sometimes it won't be. So you could theoretically actually cut mask a little bit on the inside edge. So it, if it expands the can a tiny bit, and it will usually match the colors, it won't be too detrimental to the image. But like this one here, that's a little too big. I haven't fully tested this out with a lot of other products yet. So this is really, you know, I'm going to probably make more, a few more videos using different products because it probably requires slightly different methods. This one so far seems to work. I usually get a hand holding. Oh, we might be getting one here. Nope, this one's going to be messed up. So let's go ahead with that. We'll go into advanced. I'm going to go in here and turn that off for now, because I'm done using that. And I'm going to drag this down here. So that's the image that we'll be using. I think that's a good start. Now, the thing is, if the background isn't what you want, that's not necessarily an issue. A lot of times if you're doing it certain, like this, the way I'm doing it, the biggest thing I find is to get the hand product placement correct. Then you can inpaint out some of the other stuff and regenerate. So if I don't want her to be in that sort of clothing, I could change that. That's not going to be as much of an issue. And actually, that's what I'm going to do. So now I have my initial image. So I start off with this initial image and I build out from there. If you don't need a full person, then I could say, okay, that might be fine enough. So in this example here, I'm going to go ahead and start building this out. And this is where the power of outpainting comes into play. The reason I didn't make this and start off with the can smaller, because that's one suggestion I've had, but it's much harder. When I had the can even half the size and I was trying to do this, I had a much harder time getting the fingers to come out right. I found the further back it went, the more messed up it was. But if I went too close, then you don't get enough to outpaint properly. So what I do at this point, when I do outpainting, you want to do one side at a time. And what that does is just, it's going to add onto this side, and that's pretty much it. So let's go ahead. I'll hit generate. Now, the way I do this, you can just outpaint and be done. But the problem I find is a lot of time the outpainting will leave a little bit of stitching lines. So I more or less outpaint to get the basic structure to have it build out. So the arm and stuff, because that's what I find is going to be the most important thing. I can redo the rest of it with regular inpainting. Okay, so that's good enough for me for this one. I'm going to bring this down now down to here. So we've now I'm going to, instead of doing the right, I'm going to do, let's go, I'm going to do the bottom at the moment. It doesn't really matter. And now once I get to a certain size, I'm actually going to probably take it out of here. I'll bring it back in and resize it back down to closer resolution to what we have here, and then I'll adjust it again. Okay, so I think we're going to use this image here. It's big enough for my purpose. So at that point, I'm going to go ahead and open up that image actually in whatever image editing tool that you want. All we're doing here is I'm going to resize this down to an actual resolution that is already in focus. That way we get a much better result. So let me scale the image down. 1150, yeah, that's pretty close. So let's scale that down. Let's see, canvas size 1152. Okay, now I'm gonna overwrite that. Now I've resized it to a more appropriate version here. So we've now scaled it down because remember, as this added edges and everything, it increased the size of the image. It doesn't keep rescaling it. So when you want to do the final job, if you're going to re-impaint the whole thing, like I'm going to do here, I want to get that down to a normal size. I find you get a much better results than if you try to impaint a much larger image. I'm going to drag that in. That's the one that I've now resized to the 896 to 1152. I think that's what it was. Yes. So this is now resized I have the proper size I want over here. I'm gonna increase my images, style, everything is all set. Oh, let me go ahead and just mask this out. Now, this I'm gonna do manually. And then for your prompt, you can put whatever you want in the prompt. That's entirely up to you at that point, whatever you're looking for. And I'm just gonna go ahead, I got the size correct and everything. Let's go ahead and generate. I think we have our winner. Yeah, I'm gonna go with this one. Hopefully this will help with adding real products or objects into your images using Fooocus. I will probably try some other product ideas in the future. I'm pretty happy with these results. If you have any suggestions on other ways of doing it within Fooocus, definitely leave a comment. I'm always looking for good ideas. If you found this video helpful, please hit that like button. And I'd like to again thank the viewers who have bought me a coffee. I really appreciate it. And until the next video, have a great day.